The following words were written by Corporal John Dewsbury, C Company, the Sherwood Fusiliers.
I'm writing a few lines. Severely wounded. We've done well, our battalion. Advanced about 3/4 of a mile. I'm laid in a shell hole with 2 wounds in my hip and through my back. I cannot move or crawl. I've been here 24 hours and never seen a living soul. I hope you'll receive these few lines, as I don't expect anyone will come to take me away. But you know I have done my duty out here for 1 year and 8 months. You'll always have the consolation that I died quite happy doing my duty. Must give my best of love to all the cousins who have been so kind to me the time I've been out here, and the best of love to Mother and Harry and all at home.
The note was sent to Corporal Dewsbury's mother, indicating his body was found, but in the subsequent fighting, his body or grave was lost, and he, like many others, has no known grave.
By the machine gun. Soldiers are cut down by streams of bullets. The mechanical danger must be overcome by a mechanical method. We must crush the trenches in. We must crush them in. It is the only way.
Spencer Churchill. As the war progressed, the British Army rapidly improved its tactics and the technology that it used. The new invention, the tank, was first used at the end of the Somme battles in September of 1916. Not many tanks were ready, 49 were sent to France, and they didn't perform brilliantly, but they showed enough promise for Field Marshal Haig to order 1,000. In November 1917, at the Battle of Cambrai, over 300 tanks were used with new artillery tactics, a short, sharp bombardment before the attack, infantry following their tanks through the wire, and aeroplanes attacking ground targets and reporting movement. April of 1918, for the first time on the battlefield, a tank met a tank. That was the German A7V, 3 of them attacking at a base called Villers-Bretonneux, and British tanks, Mark 4 tanks, responded. Depending on whose side you take, it could either seem a draw or that the British won to actually chase the German tanks from the battlefield. If you look at the top of the Mark 4 tank, they're actually indicating with a shovel to tell the infantry to go forward. Simple ideas like that would come up with by tank crews in the First World War so they could communicate with the infantry that were outside. see the infantry using those earlier tactics, fire and movement. There they go, they move while they're under cover of their comrades. And again, Lewis gun teams would put suppressing fire down on the enemy position so that the infantrymen could advance. The platoon, the basic section, the basic unit of the British Army. And there they are, they've captured the German position. Germany sued for peace in November of 1918, and at last the war was an end. The war had seen rapid changes in tactics and technology. It's been said that at the beginning of the First World War, the British Army would, and how it fought would have been recognised by Wellington's men 100 years before. By 1918, the tactics and the methods they were using are very similar to what the modern army performs today.